Yo, it's your boy CodeRed's Trendsetter TV. This is my acceptance speech. Last night, it was the BME Awards, and unfortunately, due to me and my crew in the parking lot getting it popping on the 420 wave, I missed actually getting the award and going on stage and giving a speech. And so I wanted to still say a few words because I felt like I owe it to a lot of people that I have to tell them thank you. You know, and whether two people watch this video or 1,000 people watch this video, it still needs to be said. I still need to get that out. So, you know, I am the recipient. Did I say that right? I don't know. I'm kind of on a little wave right now. Of the Boston's Most Elite Awards 2012 Video Man of the Year, it's your boy CodeRed, Trendsetter TV. You know, I'm official. I'm stupid official right now. You know what I mean? And I wanted to say thank you to some people. They deserve it. Because this wasn't an individual effort, you know? So it won't take up too much of your time, people. But yeah, shout out to the 420 crew. You know, I was burning down stupid. So let's kick it off. Well, so I definitely have to big up God, you know, everything that I've been doing. You know, I've had my trials and my tribulations just like everybody else in the whole world has, but I felt like God has been really watching me and really been over my shoulder and really been helping me with a lot of stuff, you know, and if it wasn't for him, you know, then I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be doing this. You wouldn't be watching this video right now. I wouldn't have won this last night and the whole nine, you know. God's definitely blessed me and looked out for me, you know. I don't be in church as much as I should be, you know, and never really been a church goer, but I believe, you know, I say thank you every day, sometimes 3-4 times a day for the little stuff I have, you know. Be thankful for what you got, you know, because we could be well worse, you know what I mean? We could be a lot worse, so thank you to God, you know. Every time. I definitely want to shout out my parents, my mom, my father. None of this, of course, would have been possible without them. You know, I love my dad. You know what I mean? My dad's the man. You know, he's getting up there, but I love him, man. And my mother, is the reason why I'm an entrepreneur, you know, and she's always stressed the fact that I shouldn't work for nobody else, that I should start my own business. You know, when I was a little kid, I started a business called CKC, Cool Kids Cleaning. And I was running around cleaning people's yards and stuff. You know, and I was 13 trying to make some money, you know, trying to legally make money, you know. And my mom's was a real advocate for that. And she really wanted me to, you know, leave my own footprint in the world and to put something together myself, you know. And if it wasn't for her telling me that stuff and gearing me for the future, Trendsetter TV would not be here because that's one of my babies. You know, that's my life. You know, and that's my job. So definitely want to shout out my mom. Thanks for the encouragement. You know, I shot another video before this, and I didn't find out until the end that the sound wasn't working. The sound is definitely working. I can see it right now. Y'all can't see it, but I can see it. But sounds working. I felt like that was a good video, so I'm trying to say a lot of the same stuff that I said in that video. So if you think I'm rambling, I'm really not. I'm trying to put it all together. I want to shout out my grandmother because the last couple of weeks, my grandmother's been holding me down for a person who is barely making it herself. You know, my grandmother is helping me a lot with the baby and life, just life, you know, and trying to get me on the right path, you know, so that when they're gone, I can do this on my own, you know, and I've been doing it, but it's always good to have help, you know. Nobody can do anything by themselves. Everybody needs at least somebody, you know, and they're my rocks, you know. God, my parents, and my grandmother, they're my rocks, you know. I love you, Grandma. I want to shout out to everybody who voted, man. From all over the place, because they said we had over 500 votes, you know. We were second place to Trickstar, I think. I'm not sure, those are what people told me. But like I said, I got there late, so I didn't get to, you know, go on stage and hear the drum roll, please, and be all nervous. We walked in there swagged out, you know what I mean, me and my whole crew. And you know, we sat down, we had our drinks, we've been drinking Patron. I've been drinking Patron for the past 24 hours. And I'm going to take another sip to that. But yeah, thank you to everybody who voted. It's nice to know that people appreciate what you do, you know, and you didn't have to vote. You could have voted on anybody. There was other people in my category, too. There was two other guys, you know, in my category. You could have voted for them. Some people did, you know, but I got this. This is mine for life, you know. The sticker's still on it. But this is me. So thank you to all the voters. I appreciate it, you know. I want to shout out my homeboy Chopper. You know what I mean? Chopper the yo, Chopper, hey Russian, hey yo Ice, little insiders. I want to shout them out. You know, 99% of the time I'm behind the camera, I'm filming, I'm editing, I'm doing the whole nine. But those other percents, it's either Chopper or it's Rockstone Triz. So I want to shout out to my man Chopper. You know what I mean? Go check him out. He's doing this big thing called Casablanca Films. You know what I mean? Him and my boy Randy. They're really putting in work. They work with some big artists already. You know what I mean? They're really trying to put Boston on the map, as I have too, in my field and a different field. So, you know what I mean? Definitely go check them out. Shout out my whole squad. You know what I mean? Rockstone Triz. Rockstone Triz. If I could do the drop right now, I would do the drop. But that's my man's. Might as well be brothers, you know what I mean? I wish I was Honduranian sometimes in Trinity so I could be cool with you on that level so we could be like blood brothers, but I feel like we are, you know what I mean? Like, you my dude, my nigga, you my nigga. I'm trying to stop using the word nigga and shit, but you my nigga. You know, Rockstone Triz helped me with the Energy in the City video, you know? So every time you watch that black and white, every time you watch the video, you see that black and white picture pop up on the screen, that second shot, that's Triz. He walked around that whole Reggie Lewis that night, and he was getting behind-the-scenes footage of stuff that some of it we didn't even put out because we just kept it for us, you know what I mean? But Allison Hines, Marshall Montana, Patrice Roberts, Farmer Nappy, Mr. Walker, the whole crew, you know what I mean? He helped me with that, so, and he helped me with a bunch of other stuff. He's almost like a manager in a way, too, because he's been getting me booked with stuff, too. You know, he's talked to a lot of these promoters and was like, you know you can hire, I don't want to say any names, but you should fuck with Trendsetter TV, dog. Trendsetter TV is going to hold you down. Trendsetter TV is going to put in the work. So I appreciate you, Triz. You my dude for life. Whatever you need, you already know I got you. If I can help you, I got you, bro. You know what I mean? I want to shout out my two best friends in the whole world, dog. The whole world. Yeah, man, I say it like a reggae man. And I'm not Jamaican at all. All that accent is developed over the course of 10 years from listening to Cartel. You know what I mean? So I ain't never lie and say I was Jamaican or nothing. You know what I mean? All that shit's been developed. But I want to shout out my dudes Danny and my dudes Edwin. Edwin's the best barber in the city. You know what I mean? Shout out to Boom Cuts. I know you're nice, but my nigga Edwin's better. Shout out to my dude Danny. We've been friends since sixth grade, since Pokemon. You know what I mean? And they came through last night. They didn't really know what to wear. You know what I mean? We all thought we was late, even though we was token. But, you know what I mean? They came through and showed their support. And I appreciate that because y'all didn't have to, man. You know what I mean? They don't do the reggae thing. You know what I mean? They don't be in a club. They don't see the style. You know what I mean? They don't know that we on a whole other planet. You know what I mean? They still came through. And they was like, yo, we out here to support you, man. You know what I mean? And I respect that. I appreciate that. I love that. Like, thank you. You know? Thank you. You know? Somberly. Thank you. I want to shout out a couple people from the awards last night who got awards. But first, before I shout them out, I want to shout out Rushy Boo. I have to shout out Rushy Boo in the whole BME awards for putting it together. You know what I mean? A lot of people talk about putting stuff together and they never do it. You know what I mean? It's just, we're about to do this. And yo, I'm about to blow up. And yo, I got a mixtape coming out. And yo, I got this. I got a new album coming out. It's all talk. Y'all did it. You know what I mean? Y'all actually did it. A lot of people are going to criticize it. They're going to say, you know, nobody came. People came. Russell Auditorium is a big place to fill for any event. Tony Montserrat had a hard time filling that club up. And, you know, the price was one thing, but so what? You know what I mean? no matter what it is, stop trying to get into the club for free. Pay your way in. You know what I mean? Because if it was your event, you'd want people to pay for free. You would want people to pay. You wouldn't want everybody to be coming in for free. You know what I'm saying? So, shout out to Rushy Boo and the whole crew. I don't really know everybody who was behind the scenes of it, so I'm putting it all in a box. I don't really mean to. But, you know, me and Rushy have been talking and stuff, and she's good people's, dog. She's real good people's. They had a really good vision and were putting this together, and they did it. Like I said, they did it, and it was amazing. The decor was nice. The balloons was nice. It was nice. I really wish I would have came on stage and grabbed the award, you know what I mean? But I couldn't. It's all good. And you looked fabulous that night, you know? Shout out to Smalley. I have to shout out to Smalley, too. I'm going to shout out Smalley for a different reason. I'm going to shout out Smalley because Smalley's a real dancer. And only real dancers will know that she's a real dancer. You know, no matter what happens during your show, the show must go on. The show must go on. The DJ was fucking up a little bit. Smalley went over there. Hey, yo, let me tell you this. You know what I mean? Got right, went back on stage, and danced her ass off, yo. You know what I mean? Danced her ass off. Real performer. No matter what happens, the show must go on. My mom's a choreographer. You know what I mean? She's always stressing an 8 count, stressing a 4 count, stressing being in sync. You know what I mean? And it really shows, you know? Smalley has that, you know? And Smalley went up there by herself, and she she showed why she's the dance hall queen of Boston. Shout out to Yaya, too. You know, I know you are, too. But Smalley puts on a show every time, and I appreciated watching it, you know what I mean? It took me back to the day when I was doing my Pasta Pasta 1-2, you know what I mean? So I can respect you. I can respect you on that, you know? Shout out to Clean Crew every time. Y'all are some of the freshest niggas I ever seen. Some of the freshest niggas I ever seen. Real talk, real talk. You know, since I've been coming up in Boston, I've been doing this whole reggae Pasta Pasta thing since 2001. Shout out to my homeboy Kevin, who brought me to my first party at the White Church. My first party ever. I lied to my parents to go to that and everything. I was like, yeah, we might just go to a sleepover and hang out. You know, I went down to the White Church over there in Roxbury. Big up Roxbury. That's my town. That's where I'm at right now. I'm filming from Roxbury, live from the main cave. The honeycomb hideout is like I call it. No puns intended, kinda. But shout out to Clean Crew. I got a little Patron in my cup. This is for y'all. Y'all are some fresh dudes. I respect it. You know what I mean? Y'all made me step my game up too. I tried to come right because I knew that the competition was going to be fierce last night. So I had to put my stamp on it in some way. But y'all been doing it as long as I've been doing it, if not longer. You know, people like y'all, people like Tallis, people like VAC, people like Rara, people like Solly. It's who I looked up to dancing, you know, when I came up. You know, I started off DJing and I was doing that for a little bit. And then I would play a big tune, and then I would try to go dance, and the tune would play out. And then everybody's looking around like, oh, where's the DJ at? And I'm cuffing in the back somewhere. I got a bitch in the back somewhere chilling. No disrespect to girls, but you know what I mean? I'm doing my thug dizzle, and the song is playing out. So I had to choose. So I chose to stick with dancing for a little bit. So I've been dancing, you know what I mean? And you are the guys who I look up to. Like I said, Tallis. Like I said, rah-rah. Where's Rara, man? I think Rara's in New York getting it popping. Shout out to Solly. I know Solly was doing his soccer thing, too. You know what I mean? But you guys are the guys I looked up to, man. I used to go to Club ID or Who's On First in Fenway. And I would just stand there and watch you guys in straight amazement. And then go home and practice. And practice these steps, man. You know what I mean? A ba-da-da. You know what I mean? A ba-da-da. You know what I mean? So, shout out to you guys, man. Definitely shout out to you guys, man. Shout out to Tallis. Shout out to Clean Crew. Tallis, I see you, man. I see you, Tallis, man. You know, I just started a family. I know you got a family, too. And it's tough. You know what I mean? It's tough, but it's so enjoying. You know, it's fulfilling, I should say. And you know what I mean? I see you. We don't get to talk as much. Like I said about, you know, Clean Crew, we don't get to talk as much. You know what I mean? But, you know, a fisherman sees another fisherman from afar. You know what I mean? And I see you guys. So trendsetter salute to y'all. Y'all some real trendsetters in what y'all do. Keep it up. Because y'all make dance hall fun. When I go to the club, when I go to K's Oasis, I don't really go to K's Oasis like that. But when I go to K's Oasis and I see y'all there, I feel at home. You know what I mean? I'm like, yeah, we in the building. Or if I'm abroad, if I'm in New York and we at a party, or I'm in ATL or wherever the fuck I'm at, You know, I mean, I miss being in Boston. I miss seeing familiar faces. And you guys are the faces that I look for when I go to the club. You know what I mean? Because it's like, yep, if y'all are in here, it's a party. It's a party, man. You know what I mean? Shout out to Trickstar. Trickstar got over 800 votes? 800 votes. That's what's up, bro. 800 votes is hard to come by. You know what I mean? And I know you rallied the troops to get that together, and I ain't mad at you, dog. That's what's up. That's what you gotta do if you wanna win. You gotta win, man. Win is win. Win is win. It's just that simple. Win is win. And Trickstar is a winner. Trickstar got 80% of y'all's profile picture. He took it. That's what's up. He can say, that's my picture. That's my picture. That's my picture. You know what I'm saying? And people hate on Trickstar because of whatever. Who gives a fuck? Trickstar is doing it. A lot of other motherfuckers ain't doing it. You know what I mean? So before y'all cast some hate on Trickstar, try to figure out why you ain't doing it, bro. Real talk. Real talk. So shout out to Trickstar. I know we had a little issue at the club the other night, but it's all good, dog. You know what I mean? My crew was in there banging. I got to jump in that shit. So, you know what I mean? Pearsons and all. You know what I mean? Don't matter. It don't matter, dog. It don't matter. So I respect you, Trick. You know, keep up the good work, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like Trizza said, the money's about to start piling up, if it's not already. You know what I'm saying? So shout out to Trickstar. I want to shout out a bunch of people I really look up to on a DJ tip. You know what I'm saying? People who paved the way for me and a bunch of other people. A bunch of other people. Shout out to Cypress and Biggie. They won last night too. You know, shout out to Rodigan. Shout out to Dex. Shout out to Drew Knight. Shout out to Chubby Chubb. You know, these are people I look up to. You know what I'm saying? As a DJ. And I wouldn't even consider myself a DJ yet. You know, I used to call myself DJ CodeRed back in 01, 02. But as of now, I'm taking it off because I don't feel like I'm a DJ yet. Since I got back on Big City, I've been taking DJing full time. And I've been trying to get back to the way I used to have it. You know, I got a bunch of CDs over there too. Just like a lot of you other DJs, you know what I mean? I got CDs too. And they all say CodeRed, you know what I mean? DJ CodeRed 2003. You know what I'm saying? So, another one. 04. You know what I mean? I was doing it, you know? And I kind of stayed away from it because, like I said, you know, I had to choose. I had to choose between dancing and DJing because it was becoming an issue with the party and songs playing out and stuff like that. So I chose to stick with dancing for a little bit. And now that I'm back on Big City with the best radio station in Boston, honestly. You can say underground, you can say pirate station if you want to, but we the best. We the best. We play the music people want to hear. You know, shout out to Dex. He's like a big brother to me, you know. He's trying to get me on the right path. He's been bringing me to DJ things and showing me how to scratch and the whole nine, you know what I mean? And respect to you. Shout out to Drew Nice. You know, he just linked up on trendsetterradio.com. He didn't have to. He could have went to any other radio station, dog. He's a heavy hitter, you know. He's big mind, you know what I mean? But he's fucking with us, you know, and I respect that. I respect all you guys, you know, Cypress. I don't know nobody who busts reggae in Boston like you bust reggae in Boston, man. Who busts dancehall in Boston, dog. Who busts a cartel tune and make me want to throw my cup because it's just that serious. It's like, yo, he just bust that tune, yo. Big up yourself, you know. And I can only hope that one day I get on a level of you guys, you know, because I look up to y'all. I look up to y'all. A lot of people don't get to tell people who they admire. They don't get to show them the respect that they deserve until it's too late, until they're laying in the casket or some shit, you know. But let this video be the proof that, you know, I respect you guys. And I'm telling you thank you because y'all don't know, but I watch. I sit back and I go behind a DJ booth. I take notes. You know what I mean? Excuse me. And I watch the juggling. I watch the sound selection, the music selection. I watch how you guys, how Sound International builds up the speakers. You know what I mean? And I sit there and I watch. And it's like, I can only hope to one day carry that torch in a few years. Because I know you guys ain't going to be able to do it forever. You know, that's my phone going off. But they can wait. Like I said, you know, I watch you guys. You guys are cool. Like, you guys are cool to me. You know what I mean? And if it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing. Because I'm like, you know, I want to, like I said, carry the torch. One day. You know, Rodigan's just banged out 25 years, meaning he's been DJing longer than I've been alive. You know? Phone's on blast right now. He's been DJing as long as I've been alive, and it's like, I could only hope to be on that level one day and hold down Boston level like that, you know, and have the respect that Rodigan has, like, 25 years, man. Not everybody can do this. This is a marathon. A lot of people get it confused with a race, and they want to just put out some shit, throw a quick party, and think that's going to do it. They're in it for the wrong reasons. They're in it just to be popular. These people like Rodigan, like Cypress, like Dex, like Biggie, you know, these people put in work. You know what I mean? They're at all these events all the time. They got the online radio popping. They got mixtapes. They got everything. Media, everything. You know what I mean? And I'm trying. You know what I mean? Single-handedly, I'm trying to get it popping like y'all, man. You know, so respect to you guys. And you know I have to send respect to Big City. You know, that's my family. You know, I tried to get on Wave. Wave wasn't fucking with me. You know, they wasn't fucking with me. But Big City took me in. You know, shout out to Dex, like I said. Dex put me in there, you know, and I appreciate that. That's what's up. Rodigan, yeah, that's what's up. 25 years, that's what's up, bro. That's what's up. But Big City, shout out to Richie. And I'm going to shout out Richie for a different reason. I'm going to shout out Richie because... Told you why my phone was going off. I'm going to shout out Richie because Richie taught me how to be a businessman. You know what I mean? Like, he showed me how to run a radio station, you know? And I'm not saying I run Trendsetter Radio the best, but I'm trying. And I'm trying to model it after the way that Richie did it, you know? And Richie's, oh. You know, a lot of people think Richie's an asshole because he don't got time for bullshit. But that doesn't mean he's an asshole. He just don't got time for bullshit. You know what I mean? You come at Richie correct. You come at Richie with some money. You know what I mean? With a good idea. And he'll fuck with you. He'll come through, build the sound. He'll come through and jump on the mic. And he'll tear it up. You know what I mean? And not everybody can do that. I've seen Richie tear up parties, dog. Tear up parties, man. And this dude's been around for 20 plus years. You know what I mean? Put the trophy down for a second. But Richie's been around for forever. You know what I'm saying? So... I respect y'all. That's what's up. I respect y'all. Thanks for putting me on Big City, you know, because it helped further my career, you know, wherever it does go, because it can go anywhere, you know what I mean? Y'all didn't have to put me on, and y'all did. You know, I had no radio experience. No radio experience, man. So shout out to Snack Shop Crew. We didn't win, but, I mean, we lost to Rodigan. I mean, I don't even take it as a loss. I mean, it's Rodigan. You know, it's Rodigan. I didn't give it to Rodigan. We was just trying. We was trying to compete. You know what I mean? We was trying. But Rodigan, Drive Time Show, big up yourself, you know? I definitely want to shout out a couple other people. We almost out of here. Let me say this. Hard work pays off, people. Hard work pays off tremendously. You know, I put out over 100 videos. We're at 940,000 views on YouTube. Let me say that again. 940,000 plus views on YouTube. That didn't come overnight. That came with hard work and determination. And it's like, you know, it's a joy to see that people appreciate what you're putting out, you know, and I'm happy that you guys watch a video. I'm happy if you guys share it. I'm happy if you guys dislike a video, if they put the thumb down. It's cool because then I know for the next video what y'all like, what y'all don't like, and I can kind of tailor make it towards that, you know? So... Hard work pays off. Whatever you're trying to do, if you're trying to be a rapper, you're trying to be a singer, you're trying to be a dancer, hit the gym. You're trying to be a basketball star, hit the gym, man. Be in there all the time. You know, I got a list up on my wall of all the stuff that I practice every day on the DJ tip. All my scratches, all my blends, all my beat matching, all that stuff. And I practice that shit every day. You see the post-its up? Those are all my notes. That's how I take notes, you know? I got post-its all over my laptop of notes that I want, people I want to thank. You know what I mean? And y'all don't see it, but they're all over my computer. So practice does make perfect. And a lot of people think there's a shortcut to success. There's not. You know what I mean? You got to put in work. Like Diddy said, you got to put in work. If you want it bad enough, you'll walk. You know? And whatever it is, you know, whatever you're trying to be, just put the work in. And it'll show. It might take long, but, you know, Justin Bieber getting it popping in his teenage years and you getting it popping when you're 30. You can't compare that. That's not your story. You know what I mean? Justin Bieber got it popping. That's his story. You getting it popping at 30 years old or whatever the case may be, 20, whatever the case may be, is that's your story. You know what I'm saying? So You just keep pushing it. Don't let these other people defer you. Don't let these other people say you're too old. Don't let these older, some of the older DJs get mad at the younger DJs because we have controllers. Like, I got my NS6, so what? You know what I mean? Don't be mad because the technology is in our favor right now. You know what I mean? That's like walking around with a cassette player. We don't do that. You know what I mean? Nobody does that. You know what I mean? Some people still juggle with CDs. You know what I mean? But everybody else got Serato. They got Itch. They got Tractor on their laptops, and that's how they roll, you know? So, you know what I mean? Just do what you do. Just do what you do. It'll pay off. If you're doing good and you're doing the right shit, it'll pay off. You know what I mean? So, and on top of that, it's nice to be nominated for something, dog. You know, to know that over 500 people voted for this. Over 500, you know, votes. I'm not going to say people because I don't know how many people voted multiple times. But that's what's up. If you voted multiple times, if you didn't, if you shared it, if you did all the stuff, man, I want to thank you because Boston's a, hard place to get it popping at. It's not like New York, you know. Boston's smaller. People know you here. People know you personally. People watch you grow up. People watch me, you know. I lived all over Roxbury, you know, and I've been growing up with the same people you see me in the parties with. You know, shout out to my street, St. James. You know what I mean? I'm not a hood nigga, but I chill with hood niggas, and they get it popping. So, you know what I mean? But shout out to Colbert, shout out to Scooter, shout out to Derek, shout out to Kyle, shout out to everybody, man. Kwame, who passed, shout out to him, you know. Rest in peace to you, you know, and it's nice to be nominated. You know, like I said, crabs in a barrel. Let you step out the barrel, the bucket. You know, they'll pull you back in, man. You know, Boston don't want nobody else to pop off because they're not popping off. And they're kind of tight that they're not popping off. You know what I mean? But if you're putting in hard work and shit, don't be mad. Don't be mad, dog. You know what I mean? There's a lot of promoters that put in stupid work out here, dog. You know what I mean? There's so much talent in Boston, man. You know, and Trendsetter TV is trying to help you guys get on the map. You know, Trendsetter TV is, we film anything that's trendsetting from parties to fashion to anything. If it's popping, I want to show the world, you know, and 940,000 views, that's worldwide, you know, through the grace of the internet and YouTube, you know, and I thank you. We have over 1,700 subscribers. 1,700 subscribers? What? I mean, 1,700 people care about what I'm putting out, and I thank you for watching, you know. Shout out to anybody who's ever watched a YouTube video, one of my videos. Shout out to anybody who's ever watched one, you know, and shout out to anybody who's ever shared it. Like I said, you know, I appreciate that. I think I bigged up everybody. I want to big up three main people before I get out of here. I'm trying to keep this under 30 minutes. Shout out to Scrappy in Jamaica. He's the one who put together Pasa Pasa videos. He's the reason why there's a Trendsetter TV. And I've never met this guy. But I've had from Pasa Pasa 20 all the way to Pasa Pasa like 63. You know what I mean? And he put Jamaica on the map. And I'm trying to do the same thing for Boston. You know, he showed that there was a way to make money and to help out your city all at the same time. You know, all at the same time. So it's like, it's possible, you know? So shout out to a guy I've never met, but a guy who's completely inspired a lot of what I do. You know, so big up Scrappy. Real niggas know who Scrappy is. If you ever watched the Pasa Pasa, I think of Medi Mondays, it's because of him, you know what I mean? So, that's to you, bro. Maybe one day we can link up and work together, man. Maybe we can do some cartel stuff, man. I'm trying to get my green card ready so I can go down to Jamaica. My visa. Another person I have to shout out is Yazzie. None of this would have been possible without my girl Yazzie, man. She's the one who bought me my first camera. You know, and it was a shitty camera. It's about this big. I had tape around it with a flashlight, LED flashlight on it. And I was running around parties filming and stuff like that. And the quality was horrible. Everything was horrible. You know what I mean? But she got my first camera. And they said behind every good woman. I mean, behind every good man is a good woman. And she's definitely that good woman. So, I love you. This is to you. And coincidentally, my son turned 8 months yesterday when I got the award. So this is dedicated to him. It's dedicated to my son, Zayden. You are a joy, you know. I was scared to be a father. I really was because I didn't think I was going to be good enough. But, you know, every time I look at you, man, and you go like this, it's trying to help me pick you up, man. I love it. You know, I love it, man. Your daddy's out here trying. I'm trying to get it together so we can have a better life, you know. I'm really trying to get it popping. So thank you to everybody who voted. Thank you to everybody who's watched the video. You know, I'm about to be at 30 minutes. So thank you again. Trent said a salute.